Hi, hello, my dears and my dear buddies. So, welcome to this video. So, I hope you are all fine and healthy. This is the first class for us, I think, is it? Yes. So, in the first class, we are going to see the first part. First unit, the first part of the lesson is prose. Okay. So the title of the lesson is His First Flight. His First Flight. Before go to this lesson, I want to ask some questions to you. So in our life, we are all having the dreams, I think. Is it or not? So in our dream, we are all having the dreams. So we want to become a doctor or anything. You are having that aim, ambition. So all of those things we are having. Is it or not? So even though I am also having that dream. So I want to achieve my grade level into the higher. So that's why I am having that dream. Yes. So in this story, in this lesson, what they are shown to us means they are just shown the courage. So how to overcome the fear? Suppose you are just entering into the 10th standard now. So you are having some fear with you. You are having some fear with you. How I can get good marks? How I can reach my goal? So you are having that questions among yourself. Is it or not? So you have to overcome with your challenges. You have to overcome with your fear, afraid, frightened. So you have to overcome that. So we have to face a lot of difficult tasks in our life. So we have to overcome with our challenges. So here there was the one bird. One bird. How it overcomes the fear? How it overcomes the fear? So that's the theme of this lesson. So what's the theme of this lesson is the courage, overcoming fear, trusting his own ability. First of all, you have to believe yourself. That's the main thing. So you have to believe yourself. If you believe you means, if you believe yourself means you can achieve many levels. You can achieve a lot of things in the world. Is it clear? Yes. So don't be afraid of 10th standard. In the first lesson itself, they are just giving about this courage, overcoming fear, trusting his own ability. I think this is up to you. Up to you. Why? Because you are first time going to attend the public exam. So you have to overcome the challenges. That's why the government just giving this lesson, I think, to you. Yes. So first of all, before go to this lesson, we have to learn about the poet. We have to learn about the poet. So the poet's author name was Liam O'Flaherty. Liam O'Flaherty. Is it clear? So he is the author of this, his first flight. So this Liam O'Flaherty is an Irish novelist. He is an Irish novelist and short story writer. He is an Irish novelist and he is a short story writer. He was a founding members of the communist. He was a founding member of the Communist Party of Ireland. Okay, he spent most of the time in traveling only, and he lived comfortably and quietly outside the spotlight. So he is an Irish novelist, short story writer, and a major figure in the Irish literary Renaissance. So you understood this about this author. He is an Irish short story writer as well as the novelist. I think you understood about this. Yes. First, the story begins with one young seagull. The story begins with one young seagull. Okay, wow. So what is meant by seagull? Seagull means, what is that means? So seagull, a bird that lives near the sea and has short legs, long wings, white and grey feathers. So this is the meaning for this seagull. It's one of the bird. It lives only in the sea only. So, and it has short legs, long wings and white and grey feathers. So there was a one young seagull. So it was a young seagull means he cannot know how to fly. He cannot know how to fly. So he has some afraid. He has some afraid to fly. So while you are in the childhood days, you can notice or you can ask your mom why you started to walk. The first time you are having the fear. We cannot be able to place our foot in the here. So we cannot place. We cannot place the foot in down. So we are having some fear. So we are having some fear.
Move to the another place of ledge. So what is mean by ledge? It's
mother is, so the mother has some concern, mama. So you can also realize it. So if you make fight among with your mother or father means, so hereafter I don't want to eat. You can say like this only, hereafter I don't. But mother has a love and a concern towards. Is it or not? Yes, like a way. Here also, the mother seagull, wandering here and there because of the hungry. Because of the hungry, he is wandering here and there. So the mother seagull is watching all those things. So he is just able to fly. The mother seagull is able to fly. So what she done means, she just take one piece of the dog fish, just take that dog fish and she just move and fly near with this young seagull. But that mother seagull not give that food to young seagull. Why? Because of that hungry, starvation is able to fly. So at last what happens is, because of the starvation and the hungry, this young seagull, he is ready. First time he just falling down only, he just fear about seeing the green, seeing the downstairs. So the next time he is just overcome with his fear, overcome with his challenges, and this young seagull finally he just fly. Here the story ends up. Yes, so what in this story they are, what message they are conveying means, so we cannot do this, I cannot able to do this. So don't we think like this. We have to overcome the challenge, we have to overcome with the fear, we have to overcome with fear. First of all, you have to believe yourself. So the young seagull, he did not having that confidence, he did not having that confidence. That's why he makes later to fly. Is it or not? So first believe yourself. You can do it. You can believe. You are having the capacity and the ability and the potential. So like a young seagull, you also started to fly. That's why I want to say to you. So you are moving to 10th standard now. So you also just like this young seagull, you also make to fly. Because of this 10th standard, answer 12th standard is, you are going to fly. If you overcome this challenge, you can attain your goal. So this message I want to convey to you. I think this story is clear to you. So the next class, I will show many grammar codes as well as we will move on to the next part. So before that, so here I am writing some new codes. So plunge, what is meaning by plunge means jump or dive. You can say that is jump or dive. Muster means gather. Upriding means scold. Plantably, sand. Scrabble, discard. Preening, tidy and preen its feathers. So the next one, cowardice, lack of bravery. Utter, make your sound with one's voice. Hackle, harsh way. Shrilly, loudly or forcefully. Beckoning, gesture. So these are the new words. So you are having the book in your hand, I think. So you just read the lesson line by line. Yes? So using these new words with meanings, you can understand the lesson easily. So make to start to read this lesson. If you are having doubts, we can meet, we can see as the GeoMeet app. So the next class we will see with the new section. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.